Hi guys, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
Hi folks, welcome to the first video on Kotlin tutorials. Well, if you follow CodeTutor, this is not the first time that I have talked about Kotlin. Almost 2 years back in, I think, August 2017, I had created a video on Kotlin as a part of Developer Insight series. And I actually suggest either stop this and go back there and watch that video, or after watching this particular video, you go and watch that particular video. I will be giving you the link where I basically talked about what is this big deal about Kotlin and why Google is so gung-ho about adopting Kotlin for Android application development. What is the programming language? What are its features? What happens to Java? What happens to Java-based Android development? So if you want to get a background about all that, you can just watch that particular video. Much water has flown under the bridge after that particular video. And now I am about to get started with the Kotlin Fundamentals course. I'm sure you would be wondering, how serious should I take this particular Kotlin programming language from future Java development or Android application development perspective? Well, in this particular video, I wanted to just show you some statistics so that you become aware why Kotlin is an important programming language and why it can't be ignored. After Google announced the introduction of Kotlin support in 2017, the Kotlin usage has doubled since 2017. The adoption among students community has also increased. You might be wondering, how is this relevant? But this is very, very important. If you watch my one of the other videos in which I explained how Java ended up becoming the programming language for Android application development, it starts making sense why adoption of a programming language among the student community can be a major role to play whenever a success of a programming language comes into picture. So it's no wonder this is also helping growth of Kotlin as a programming language. Other than that, who are these people who are adopting Kotlin? Well, people come from very different background, like C++, C#, Swift, but the major aggressive adopters of Kotlin are Java developers. This should not come as a surprise at all, because at the end of the day, you are converting your Kotlin code into a JVM compatible bytecode, and your Kotlin code works side by side with Java code. It is no wonder that Java developers are adopters of Kotlin. And when it comes to who are the people who are adopting Kotlin language as a mode of programming language for the application development, this is a very important statistic. That is, 60% of the projects that are currently being done, at least using Java, are adopting Kotlin. Especially, adoption is high among freelancers and students rather than professional developers. There is actually a reason for this, because most of the companies don't deal with the code bases that are 100% Kotlin. Most of the old code bases are Java, and these legacy code bases have to be supported. So what happens is, still older modules are in Java, and newer modules that typically newer developers write, they write using Kotlin. And especially since Kotlin works with Java without any problem, what is happening is, if you are a freelance developer or if you are doing any personal hobby development, you don't have any shackles on you and you can completely adopt Kotlin for 100% pure Kotlin based development. If you are working in a team environment where already legacy code exists or already people who are not familiar with Kotlin, then probably you will be forced to write your code which most of people understand, which is still Java, or at least write your modules in Kotlin but still deal with a lot of Java code. So you cannot say that I am completely going to ignore Java and only going to write my application in Kotlin. Whether we like it or not, we have to be familiar with Java and Kotlin to be able to survive in this environment. And when it comes to migrating the Java code to Kotlin, most of the people seem to be using the wizards that are part of the IDE. Android Studio has it, IntelliJ has it. So they basically convert a .java class, a .java file into a .kt file and just convert application into Kotlin application. But there is still manual rewriting that you still need to
do. It's not like I'm going to write Java code and just use a wizard to convert that particular code into Kotlin code. That is of not really much help, and that will not even help you to leverage power of Kotlin. And Android Studio is the most prevalent IDE that is using Kotlin. And the main reason is Android application development has now majorly shifted to Kotlin-based development. You can see that almost 80% of native Android mobile applications that are being written are Kotlin-based. But this still doesn't take away the fact that you still need to be familiar with Java, because I explained a few moments back that you have to be aware of both Java and Kotlin. So having gone through all these statistics, you might be either very surprised at these numbers or even anxious about another new programming language. But the fact remains that it is now time for you to take Kotlin seriously as a programming language, as an alternative to Java, and as a programming language for Android application development.
I think with this, now you might have come around the fact that why you need to learn Kotlin in 2019. So how will I be structuring this particular tutorial? Well, this tutorial is not for beginners. This is not for those people who have not done any programming and they are just starting to learn what is programming, what are variables, what are constructs like if, else. This coding tutorial is not for them. This tutorial is mainly meant for those people who have done some kind of coding, be it C#, Java, and now they want to learn Kotlin programming language and basically want to adopt Kotlin as the programming language for Android. So I will be using Kotlin 1.3, which is the most recent version of Kotlin, and I will be taking you through how to write a very basic simple Kotlin code in the next video. So till then, take care, bye.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.